Have you ever wondered why bees should be considered one of man's best friends? Or which country produces the most honey? Or how about why some bees sting and some don't? Well, here's your chance to get more fun facts about bees than ever before, and to find out how you can even help the bees that live in your own backyard. It's The Buzz About Bees. It is true that some people are extremely frightened by bees. A fear of bees is known as apophobia or melissophobia.
Stand back. These are winter boots.
Don't kill him.
You know I'm allergic to them. This thing could kill me.
But the truth is that a bee that is away from the hive looking for nectar or pollen will rarely sting.
Everybody knows you sting someone, you die. You don't waste it on a squirrel. He was such a hothead.
So the next time you see a bee, don't be scared. If you save a bee, you are actually helping everyone around you.
Here, have a crumb.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah.
Throughout history, the bees have actually faced many hazards.
And you'll be happy to know that bees haven't had one day off in 27 million years.
Woo.
In that time, they have had to endure freezing weather, scorching heat waves, and many different types of honey thieves, including large bears.
How would you like his big hairy head crashing through your living room, biting into your couch, spitting out your throw pillows? Rawr! Rawr! Okay, that's enough. Take him away.
Throughout the world, there are over 50 million bee colonies that are cared for by beekeepers.
They make the honey, and we make the money.
Most beekeepers care for bees by keeping the hives warm in the winter and cool in the summer. During the spring and fall, the beekeepers make sure the hive is kept close to flowers that are full of nectar.
I had no idea.
In China, the leading producer of honey, they have raised honeybees for over 2,000 years. And in the USA, the third largest producer of honey, there are nearly 4 million bee colonies, tended to by over 200,000 different beekeepers. Argentina is the largest honey-producing country in South America due to all of their pasture crops. France is the leading honey maker in Europe, due in part to all of the flowers they grow to help with the production of perfume. On a worldwide basis, there is over 1 million tons of honey harvested each year.
Well, that's our whole SAT test right there.
While honey is the number one thing made by bees...
You know what? I don't even like honey! I don't eat it!
They also produce other useful products, like beeswax. Beeswax is secreted by the bees and used to make their honeycomb.
I didn't know that.
Honeybees may consume 8 to 20 pounds of honey to produce just 1 pound of wax.
How could they never have told us that?
Beeswax is naturally more tacky and flexible than petroleum-based wax, so the resulting wax is stickier, making it perfect to use as surfboard wax.
Woo! That bowl is gnarly!
There are many products made from beeswax, like all-natural candles, lipstick, and crayons. A piece of thread is made stronger by dipping it in beeswax before using it to sew.
It's the greatest thing in the world. I was excited to be a part of making it.
Perhaps the honeybee's greatest contribution to everyone is pollination. Pollination is a prerequisite for fertilization, and fertilization allows flowers to develop seeds that, in turn, create more flowers. It's a never-ending cycle.
All right, scramble jocks, it's time to fly.
In nature's economy, bees are an important provider to flowering plants, who pay the bees with food for the pollination and for their offspring.
Pick up some pollen over here, sprinkle it over here. Maybe a dash over there, a pinch on that one. It's a little bit of magic, ain't it?
Wow, that's amazing.
So while the bees are out collecting nectar to produce honey, they pollinate our crops, gardens, and trees.
Look at that. That's more pollen than you and I will ever see in a lifetime.
As a matter of fact, nearly $1 billion worth of crops a year in the United States alone rely on bee pollination for continued growth. And nearly 25% of the food consumed in the United States is from plants pollinated by honeybees.
Fruits, vegetables, they all need bees.
Examples of crops that rely on honeybees are alfalfa, almonds, apples,
apricots, asparagus, avocados, blackberries, blueberries, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, cabbage, cantaloupes, carrots, cherries, cucumbers, cotton, cucumbers, honeyberries, carrots, onions, raspberries, strawberries, squash, cucumber, carrots,
and watermelons.
So if there's no more pollination, it could all just go south here, couldn't it?
Honeybees have been disappearing in huge numbers for a variety of reasons.
See that? He's dead. Dead. Another dead one. Deady. Deadified. Two more dead. Dead from the neck up. Dead from the neck down. But that's life.
But one thing is for sure. The bees need our help. And one way to help is to build a bee-friendly garden. It's easy to do. Just follow these simple guidelines. Plant bee-friendly plants and flowers like daisies, zinnia, and sunflowers. In fact, bees tend to be attracted to most any flowers that are blue, purple, and yellow.
Did you see the giant flower?
What giant flower? Where? Of course I saw the flower! That was genius, man! Genius!
As for plants, bees like sage, oregano, lavender, and mint.
Oh, those just get me psychotic!
And finally, all bees need a place where they can be safe from predators and weather. A great way to create this hotel for bees is to ask your parents to help you build a bee box.
Mom, the bees are back!
It's the ultimate hive away from home. Bee boxes are easy to make, and having these bees around will help your garden grow. To make your own bee box, follow these simple steps. 1. Find a 4x4 block of wood that has not been painted or stained. 2. Have an adult use a drill to make deep holes into the wood, being careful not to drill through to the other side. The bees will be happiest if the holes are about 3 inches deep. 3. Make sure there are no wood shavings in the holes. 4. Hang the box in an outside area that is exposed to sunlight. The bee box should be about 4 feet off the ground and placed near your trees and plants that need pollinating. 5. Step back and take a look at your new home for bees.
Barry, I told you, stop flying in the house!
So the next time you see a bee and want to swat them, remember all the good things they do. Then, put down the swatter, open the window, and let them be free. When you save a bee, you save the world.
Then follow me! Accept keychains!